Respected all, I am Himani Singh, Research Scholar from PG Department of Chemistry of University of Jammu. Today, I am here to present my work, and the title of my work is A Comprehensive Account on Physicochemical Properties of Drug in Amino Acid Solutions. Drugs used for different health issues interact with proteins in human body at many levels in digestion tract, that is from ingestion to assimilation to excretion. The interactions of drug with receptor proteins are very difficult because of the complex conformation and configuration of protein. Also, mechanism of these molecular interactions at the molecular level are still under investigation. In order to inquire the action of drugs at the molecular level, the study of interactions of drug with the biomolecules like dipeptides, amino acids, sugars is the best way. Drug delivery and controlled release technology has acknowledged extensive considerations of chemists due to its number of assets over accepted therapy, including augmented efficacy, improved patient convenience, and reduced side effects. Antibiotic is a broad term used to refer antimicrobial substances that fight against bacterial infections. The elucidation of volumetric parameters of an antibiotic in aqueous and mixed aqueous solutions is very auspicious in ascertaining and understanding its mechanism of activity. Globular proteins form a group of macromolecules which have definite physicochemical properties and functions in biological systems. The study of protein-solvent interactions is difficult because of the intricacy of the interactions in such a large molecule. However, one useful approach which can be helpful in understanding these interactions is to study simple compounds such as amino acids, which model certain aspects of protein structure. Amino acids are organic compounds containing amino and carboxyl functional groups, along with a side chain which is specific to each amino acid. The various characteristics of the solutions, that is, the stability, physical state, mobility, etc., depend upon the thermodynamic, viscometric, and transport properties. These properties include the limiting apparent molar volume, apparent molar expansibility, apparent molar compressibility, etc., and thus help in proctoring the nature of solute-solute and solute-solvent interactions. Some of the thermodynamic parameters are discussed below. The first one is the apparent molar volume. From the density estimations, the apparent molar volumes of the binary and ternary solutions can be computed applying the following equation. An apparent molar volume is represented by V5. The next one is the limiting apparent molar volume and limiting apparent molar volume of transfer. In order to have an exact illustration of solute-solvent interactions, the values of V5 of antibiotic has been used to obtain the values of limiting apparent molar volumes by fitting in Redlich-Mill equation given below. The limiting apparent molar volume of transfer provides us qualitative as well as quantitative information concerning the nature of interactions operating between solute and solvent. Because of definite dilution, the solute-solute interactions are negligible. The transfer volumes of antibiotic from water to aqueous solutions of amino acids can be calculated by making the use of the following equation 3. The next parameter is the apparent molar isentropic compression. An isentropic process in thermodynamics is described as a process in which there is no transfer of matter or heat energy and work transfers of the system are effortless. Apparent molar isentropic compression can be calculated by using the following equation 4. The variation of limiting apparent molar volume with temperature can be expressed in terms of limiting apparent molar expansibility as shown in equation 5. In order to ascertain the structure making or breaking tendency of the solute molecules in the solvent, Hepler gave the general thermodynamic equation 6. The next parameter is the caustic impedance. It can be evaluated using ultrasonic speed and density data through the use of formula given below. The empirical data is illustrated in following tables. The table 1 represents the V5 values for antibiotic in water and in aqueous amino acid solvent systems. From this table, it can be inferred that there is an enhancement in magnitude of V5 with the rise in temperature as well as molar concentrations, which signifies that the interactions between solute particles are decreasing and that of solute-solvent interactions are escalating. Table 2 represents the limiting apparent molar volumes and limiting apparent molar volume of transfer for antibiotic in water and in aqueous amino acid solutions at different temperatures. The positive value of V5 not transfer values exhibit structure promoter nature of antibiotic. Table 3 represents the apparent molar isentropic compression values for antibiotic in water and in aqueous amino acid solvent systems. Values of isentropic compression appears as negative and the magnitude decreases with increase in concentration of amino acid and temperature, which suggests that the water molecules around the antibiotic are less compressible in comparison to those present in the bulk solution that can be ascribed to strong attractive interactions. Table 4 represents the computed values of E5-naught and the Hepler constant for antibiotic in water and aqueous amino acid solutions. The values of Hepler constant have been found to be negative, thereby inferring the structure breaking affinity of the solute taken under consideration. Table 5 represents the acoustic impedance for antibiotic in water and in aqueous amino acids. It can be inferred from this table that there is an enhancement in the acoustic impedance with the rise in temperature and concentration, which indicates that there is an existence of strong intermolecular forces between antibiotic and the amino acid solvent system. By the use of experimentally obtained data of density and velocity, various parameters like apparent molar volume, limiting apparent molar volume, limiting apparent molar volume of transfer, apparent molar expansibility, apparent molar isentropic compression were computed. The apparent molar volume, that is V5, was found to be increasing with an increase in temperature, indicating the reduction in shrinkage of solute by water molecules. Moreover, the apparent molar isentropic compression was found to be progressing with temperature and molar concentration of solute. This increase in isentropic compression with rise in temperature is due to the increase in compressibility of bulk water, while that of increase in isentropic compression with concentration is due to the formation of compact structures in the solution. From the calculated values of Hepler's constant, we procured that the antibiotic taken as a solute in this case act as a structure breaker in the solvent system. Thank you.